This, as far as security is concerned, I will cover it in two parts. Firstly, it's a frustrated enemy who does involve in such activities when he is not able to face you on the borders. So it is but natural that when he is on the receiving end, he looks for easier alternative. While immediately behind the borders, we have strengthened ourselves and we are very well prepared. But when you come to the little hinterland, like the areas of, say, Udhampur or Sunjuwan or any other place, it's like a peace station for all of us, where you cannot have the same sort of a security situation to thwart this, which happens once in a way. When he really not able to do anything in the borders, then he tries to address you. So we address it in 2 to 3 different ways. As far as the borders and the immediate depth is concerned, where he could sneak in and then do some action, like it was in Uri and other places, we are very well prepared. I must tell you that since the time Uri happened, we have spent almost 364 crores on different heads to build up our security of the softer elements which are behind, especially whether it's a fence or some smart component along with the fence, and also getting your acts together as far as surveillance is concerned, the sentry duty is concerned, your drills and other things are concerned, and intelligence of course. But when you come to the depth, you all know that Indian Army has got very large number of such small units spread all across the country. So it is very difficult to do it immediately. Yes, we have prioritized the areas which are vulnerable, which needs immediate attention. So therefore the government has also earmarked certain funds, and that's flowing in, notwithstanding what recently it has been said. But we are already working on, we have different funds flowing from different heads, which we have the authority to do it, and we have done it. And what additional comes from the government, it's a bonus for us, and I am sure we will be able to not only have a physical fence, but we'll look at technology assisted one, because you can't have manpower intensive surveillance of the area. You will need the manpower on the boots on the ground on the borders. That's the first part. And as far as your second part of the question is concerned, see, I'm heading the Northern Command, and I can say with confidence that issue of Aditya has not dented the morale of my troops, not even a bit, not even an iota. I can say with confidence, because I do meet them, I move around, I speak to my command, through my commanders, I get the pulse of it. I can say it just not dented the morale at all. Because, as I mentioned, we are very clear, and our intentions are very clear. I think the deeds are there to speak. The last 1 year, have we found any human rights cases taking place? I think that's a direction which has gone from me to the entire command of mine. You will not find anyone willfully indulging in any of them. So therefore, our intentions are correct, so nothing to really worry. And secondly, it's a case which is sub judice, and the Honorable RM made a statement, and the government is totally behind, government and the Ministry of Defense is totally behind the soldiers and the armed forces. That's a statement, I think the RM made it. I think we must take it in the right spirit. I have really, I feel that Aditya's case is sub judice, it will take its course, but it hasn't really dented the morale of the Indian Army. I would say that all the three groups are hand in glove, whether it is in the valley or here, they have all almost joined. We have seen in the later part of the year in 2017, they all are hand in glove, whether it is HM, LET or the Jaish-e-Mohammed. So there is no differentiation, I would say, one, they keep jumping from one Tanzim to other. So for us, we are concerned, anyone who has picked up an arm and is against the state, he is a terrorist, and we deal with them. So whether they will be able to do something like this here, yes, now all the three coming together, so somewhere somebody is strong and somebody is weak, in whether it is in their local support or it is in the wherewithal. So if they are going to share, it's going to be a concern, so which we need to really take care of. Your point I've already addressed as far as the terrorists 214, despite elimination, the situation is not really. I want to ask you one thing. The same media, sometime in the beginning of 2017, you all said that there are three places where the Indian Army never went in: Kulgam, Pulwama, Shopian. So now you have a look. The same place the entire Indian Army goes, not only the Indian Army, you saw the political leadership, these elected members, they themselves ventured into these places where to a point you all said that no, it cannot go, it's a liberated zone, it's not there anymore. If it is there, you can let me know, we will reach out to them. That's because we reached out to both the people as well as the militants. And that is how it is able to. So when you launch more operations, there will be, the tempo will be more, there will be more contacts and more terrorists getting eliminated and some people also getting killed in the bargain, you know, or getting injured. So it is the tempo. It's one way is to just close everything, put everything under the carpet and don't do anything. Things will be fine. You will not find any of these TII, terrorist initiated incidents happening. They are cool. But one day they will all blow up. So we don't want that situation. We want the situation to come under control. See, the people of JNK and the valley, yesterday they have shown, I think it's a testimony for all those who are wanting to communalize it. I think a small stint in the armed forces would not be a bad thing. I think if any of you have visited any of our formation, even here in Udhampur, if you go, wherever our religious place is there, it's a Sarva Dharamsthal. You can go to Badami Bagh Kant, we have one. We have one here in Udhampur. I have one in my residence itself, where all the religious deities are there. So we take on the religion of our troops. We do not communalize any of them. It is only for people who don't know the inside of the functioning of the armed forces. They are the ones who are actually making these statements. I think they need to really visit all of us and then see how we put everything aside and we live together and we really do not look at any one religion from the other.